Hello, this is Akash Misar here and welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is Mechanical Engineering Make Easy. In that, we are discussing the concepts of strength of metal. This is 13th lecture of the discussion. And in previous lecture, we have started with some basic concepts like types of beams and types of loads, then types of supports. Okay, and in this lecture, we will move with shear force and bending moment. What exactly shear force and what exactly bending moment, the sign convention for that and different cases for that. Okay, we will look that concept. So let's begin for that. So shear force, what exactly shear force is that? Shear force is nothing but which causes shear. Okay, if this is one member is there and at this section the shear is occurring, so the force will be there which causes the shear, that is nothing but shear force. And what is bending moment, which causes the moment? Okay, means if one force is applied here and because of this what happened, the cross section of beam have tilted likewise. Okay, so because of this the bending of that beam is happened. Okay, so this is nothing but bending moment, which causes the moment, which causes the to bend the beam. This is nothing but bending moment. So how we can calculate the shear force? Shear force have formula, that is nothing but summation of Fy equal of left side or summation of Fy at right side. For example, this is one beam, okay, and we have one point load P at point A and we need to calculate shear force at point A. So how we can calculate? Either we will take summation of all the forces in y direction in left side of that point A, or we will consider right side of point A and calculate all the forces in y direction. Okay, this is nothing but the calculation of shear force. So here the shear force at point A will be equal to R1, which is equal to R2, and that will calculate firstly the reactions with the help of load P, that is nothing but summation of Fx equal to 0 and summation of Fy equal to 0. Okay, so this is nothing but shear force, and how we will calculate that I have shown you here. And still if you are facing any problem, then don't worry, you can ask me in comment box also. And while solving numericals, I will come up with that point. So how we are going to calculate that? Okay, next point is bending moment. How we can calculate bending moment? That is nothing but summation of moment in left side, which is also equal to summation of moment in right side. Same case as shear force. If we need to calculate moment at point A, then either we will consider the left side or we can consider right side also. By both the sides considerations, the answer we will get, that is same, no any change in answer. So if we are considering moment in left side, that will be R1 into this distance L1, and if we are considering the right side, then R2 into this distance L2. Okay, so according to that the moment will vary, but moment in left side, if we are considering the left section and if we are considering the right section, the moment will get by both the sections, the value we will get, that will be same. There will not be any change in the value. So we can consider left section also and we can consider right section also. So this is nothing but calculation of bending moment and what the formula for moment, that is force into perpendicular distance, that is nothing but moment. Okay, then we will come towards sign convention. So if we are considering shear force diagram, so how we are going to draw shear force diagram? We will calculate shear force at all the points of loading. Okay, if there is load available, then in that case the shear force will increase or decrease, and if there is no load available, in that case the shear force will not change. So ultimately we will calculate the shear force at all possible points. For example, this point and this point. We will calculate shear force at these three points, and we will denote these shear force values. For example, here the shear force is, I will simply draw one figure. Okay, this is our beam. This is horizontal line is our beam. This is point one, this is R1. So because of this R1, the shear force is this much magnitude. Then up to point A there will not be any change, but sudden here as the force is there, so it will be likewise. And likewise, this is the shear force diagram, means only considering the values of shear forces and drawing that on a with the help of line. This is nothing but shear force diagram. Okay, so for that the sign convention of for shear force, if the shear force, if we are considering the left section of this point A, and if that as this R1 is moving upward, so we will consider that value positive. And if that R1 is, for example, if here is any force and that is in downward direction, so that force we will consider negative. Okay. So likewise, we will take all the summation. For example, R1 minus this may be P2. R1 minus P2, we will get the value shear force at point A. From this direction also same we will have, if force is in downward direction then that will be positive and force is in upward direction that will be negative. So we can get value from this direction also and from this direction also, there is no any case there. Okay, this is the sign convention for shear force. And next case for sign convention for bending moment diagram. Okay, what is bending moment? Again we will calculate the bending moments at all possible points and simply draw that diagram with the help of line. There may be some parabolic curves and etc. that we will look afterwards, but firstly only consider that we have drawn bending moment. So for that sign convention, if bending moment is sagging, okay, what is this? This kind of moment is known as sagging bending moment and this kind of moment is known as hogging bending moment. Okay, these two terms are too much important. How it is sagging bending moment means, if we have considered this point A and at the left side of point A there is the moment in clockwise direction, so that will be positive. Or the moment we have considered from right side and that moment is anti-clockwise, that will be positive. But if the moment in right side that is in clockwise, then that will be negative, or the moment in left side anti-clockwise, that will be also negative. So draw these sign conventions for shear force and bending moment also, then note down these two formulas and draw this figure also. And okay, this sagging and hogging, these two terms are also too much important there. Okay, this bending moment is nothing but sagging bending moment. And if bending moment happens likewise, the beam is tilting likewise, then this is hogging bending moment and this is sagging bending moment. Okay, by the figures also I have denoted you how the hogging bending moment will be there and how sagging bending moment will be there. So just draw it, I am reviewing it. Then we will discuss the types of loading. So for different loading, how the shear force diagram will be there and how the bending moment diagram will be there. Okay, and while numerical solving, definitely I will give you idea about how we are going to draw shear force diagram, how we are going to draw bending moment diagram. Okay, but before that, just only consider for point load, the shear force diagram will be straight line and the bending moment diagram will be linear. Okay, linear means there may be inclined line or straight line, that will depend on different parameters, but only linear, no any curve will be there. The linear line means linear curve will be there. Okay, then next is, if there is UDL, that is uniformly distributed load, then in that case here the linear will be there. Linear means again there may be chances that inclined line will be there, and here square parabola. Okay, in case of bending moment, this is shear force diagram, this is bending moment diagram, and this is loading. Okay, so it is loading, shear force diagram, bending moment diagram. For point load, here straight line, here linear. For UDL, linear, square parabola. Then for UVL, there will be square parabola and here cubic parabola. Okay, means simply for UVL, for SFD will vary like square parabola and BMD will vary like cubic parabola. Then next is, there may be chances that there is parabolic force. Okay, in case of UVL, I have given you idea about that there will be triangular force only, there will not be any curvature force like parabola or etc. So if there is parabolic force, then in that case, here the cubic parabola will be there. Cubic parabola and here fourth degree parabola. Fourth degree parabola. If there is parabolic force, then देन नेक्स्ट इज इंटरनल हिंजेस. ओके इफ देर इज इंटरनल हिंज देन अल्टीमेटली व्हाट हैपन्स ऑन द हिंज देर विल बी सम मोमेंट. ओके सो अल्टीमेटली SFD will not vary, but BMD will equal to 0 directly. Because at the hinge, if this is beam and here there is hinge, hinge means two beams are connected there, and that's why the bending moment diagram will reach to directly 0. Okay. Then if there is bending couple, what is bending couple? Bending couple means simply moment. Okay, if there is concentrated moment, then again shear force will not vary, shear force variation will not be there because there is only moment. So how shear force is going to vary? Okay, and at the bending moment, okay, for bending moment there will be directly vertical step. Vertical step at that section. Vertical step at section for bending moment variation. And if there is no load, then here horizontal line and here inclined line. Okay. If there is no load, then in case of shear force diagram, there will be only horizontal line. And if there is, in case of bending moment, there will be inclined line. Okay, so these are some standard cases of loading. For that, the variation of shear force diagram, variation bending moment diagram I have given you. So these are important concepts. In that, the hinge concept is not too much important, but other concepts like moment, no load, point load, UDL and UVL, these five concepts are important. Then the concept of that parabolic load, that is also not important. Okay, so not go into too much detail into that, and because of that what will happen, you will get confused into that. That's why don't go into too much detail. Only the point load, UDL, UVL, then bending couple and no load. These five conditions are important for us. Then we will look another concept, that is point of contraflexure. Point of contraflexure, or it have another name, that is nothing but point of inflection. And what exactly it is? The point at which the bending moment changes its sign. Okay, point at which bending moment changes its sign. For example, I am drawing one bending moment diagram here. Okay, what happened? The bending moment diagram may be a parabolic curve likewise. Okay, just I have considered. So at this point what happened, the bending moment diagram have changed their sign from positive to negative. So this is nothing but point of contraflexure. Okay, the bending moment diagram changes its sign, that is nothing but point of contraflexure. And generally it point occurs for overhang beams and in between the supports. Okay, if this is one beam there, here is one support and here is one support, and this is the overhang portion. So that point will come nearly here. Okay, as this is overhang support, but ultimately what happens, in between the supports that point will be there, and for overhang beams that point will occur. Okay, this is only general case, but for some critical loadings that point may occur for different cases also. Okay, but generally for overhang beams this case happens, that is nothing but point of contraflexure, means bending moment changes its sign. Okay, so this is all about today's lecture, and now we are moving towards last topic of today's lecture, that is nothing but bonus point. So if you are enjoying my session, then please like, share and subscribe, and you can join my Telegram channel. Link is provided in description box, or simply search on Telegram our channel's name, that is Mechanical Engineering Make Easy. Okay, so bonus point for today's lecture, that is nothing but what exactly is shear force. Shear force is nothing but, okay, shear force at any section which is equal to slope of bending moment diagram at that section. ओके व्हाट एग्जैक्टली शियर फोर्स एट एनी सेक्शन विच इज इक्वल टू स्लोप ऑफ बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम एट दैट सेक्शन मीन्स सिंपली चेंजिंग मोमेंट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स और इन वाई डिरेक्शन देयर विल बी मोमेंट सो अल्टीमेटली डी वाई बाय डी एक्स इट इज नथिंग बट स्लोप ऑफ बेंडिंग मोमेंट एट दैट सेक्शन दैट इज नथिंग बट शियर फोर्स एट दैट सेक्शन It is also important as per our gate point of view. So note down this concept also. Okay, so this is what I have designed for today's lecture. And in next lecture, I will come up with the concept like center of gravity, moment of inertia, then perpendicular axis and that all the concepts. Okay, so stay tuned for that. And you can watch my all videos. I have prepared separate playlist for all the separate subjects. So go to my channel or some links are provided in description box also. Okay, so stay tuned for that and like, share and subscribe. We will meet again. Thank you, friends.